Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
You know what they say about reckoning?
I don't, but I reckon it's a lot like assuming.
Yeah, something like that.
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
And what do you say?
I say, yep, I know you didn't. Followed your case a little bit, you being a making boy and all.
You've got an opinion then?
Wouldn't say that. I go in for that innocent till proven guilty thing, even considering who they say you killed.
Be advised, medical personnel, there's a heart shield.
Any of that seem important to you?
All of it, but that box never shuts up. Sit in this seat and pay too much attention and you'll drive yourself crazy. I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
Sure.
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman.
Riot in progress. All officers are available for you coming to 17. Rolling calls and dispatches to all locations.
You'll have to learn to stop worrying about things you can't control. I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting.
All officers are available for incoming 21.
Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. And I tell him he's got to stop. But that's government property. And I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
So did he do it?
They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious, if I do say so.
Watch out!
This other time...
Thank you.
hell did he have his gun out?
Hey! Hey, officer! Are you all right? I'm still cuffed back here!
I need to drag myself out that window. Looks empty. It'll be easier to carry with these cuffs off. The officer's shotgun is over there. Looks empty. It'll be easier to carry with these cuffs off.
Officer?
God damn.
Officer? Holy shit! What in the hell? What the fuck are you? Get away from me! Shit! Where the hell are you? Do this! Someone! There's been a shooting! Hello? Anybody?
I'd fill one of those teacups with some bourbon if I could. Getting up there anyway, this leg the way it is.
Anybody up there? Somebody! Yell if you can hear me!
I wonder if anybody's home. Maybe I'll just go for a dip. Maybe I should just check inside the house through the glass door before wandering out into the neighborhood.
Is there anybody here?
I wonder if anybody's home.
Coming in. Don't shoot, okay? Ah, shit. Hello? I'm not an intruder. Or one of them.
These people might need more help than I do. What's that beeping? Marshouse. That's a Savannah area code. But that's the type of note you'd leave a babysitter. The Marsh House. That's a Savannah area code. But that's the type of note you'd leave a babysitter.
There are three new messages.
There's something on there.
Three new messages. Message one, left at 5:43 p.m.
Hey, Sandra, this is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before your spring break.
Message 2, left at 11:19 p.m.
Oh my God, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3, left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby. If you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you. We love you. We love you.
Daddy?
Huh? Hello?
You need to be quiet.
Are you okay?
I'm okay. They tried to get me, but I'm hiding until my parents come home.
What's your name?
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee. Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think, where the boats are.
Are you safe?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
That's smart.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
Man. Hi there.
Did you kill it?
I don't know. I think so.
Sometimes they come back.
You killed one?
No, but they get shot a lot.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
We need to get out of this neighborhood. It's not safe. We're less likely to be seen if we move at night.
My parents might come home.
We won't go far. We'll try to find shelter and come back here with others.
That sounds good. We can hide in my treehouse until then.
It'll be a tough climb with this leg, but that's a good idea. Let's go. Stay close to me. Now, let's stay quiet. We'll head out to the front yard and follow the road out of the neighborhood.
Okay.
It'll be okay. Stay near me, and we'll move as fast as we can.
I found the bastard!
Are we going to die?
No, I'm sure we're fine.
Stay down! Georgia State Patrol!
Dude, he won't listen to that.
We're friendly. There's a little girl here!
Shit, you're not one of those things.
Neither of us are.
Oh, damn, you've got a little girl.
We're sorry about that. Well, Andre's sorry about that.
It's Officer Mitchell.
My name's Sean. Sean Green. This is Andre.
Officer Mitchell.
Did you see any of those things? One of them just got our buddy Chet.
I saw a lot in the forest, but that was a while ago.
Yeah, one we're looking for is still in the neighborhood.
Oh, shit. You hurt your leg pretty bad. Look, help us find the thing that got our buddy, and we'll take you and your daughter down to my dad's farm to safety. He should be able to fix your leg up, too.
I'm not a dad. A neighbor. Her parents are out of town.
Whoever you are, let's get a move on.
We just were...
Oh, shit. It's Chet.
Let's go. Get to my car. Go!
No. You're kidding.
Those things got him. Dad, I don't know what's going on.
I'm sorry, Sean. You've brought a couple guests.
We just need a little help. We won't stay long.
Good. You're welcome to stay here, but just for the night. I don't run a bed and breakfast.
It's
So it's just you and your daughter, then?
Oh, not his daughter. He was her neighbor.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay, then. Well, looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah, it's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You, take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
Could be worse.
That's what it sounds like. Seems like things got awful bad in the cities. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green. How'd this happen?
Car accident.
That's so. Where are you headed before the car accident?
It smells like...
I know what it smells like.
Duty. I missed my mom and dad.
I bet, Clem.
How far is Savannah?
Pretty far.
Oh, okay.
Hey, get up.
I'm itchy.
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm not her dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence. There's a tractor and everything.
We better get going, or we won't hear the end of it. That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Duck, though.
Dodging or quacking?
Quacking.
Dad!
See? The word is, you were on your way to Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to.
I'll see what the girl would like.
Ah. Gotta consult the missus. I understand. Honey, Duck, this is Lee. And what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
I want to build a fence.
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
I can keep an eye on your little girl here on the porch. We can visit. You have such pretty hair.
It gets lots of tangles.
Hey there, girls. How did you handle getting through the city?
Kenny just drove. We passed so many people.
You know what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
Nah, no kids.
Would have liked one then.
You know. How's your son doing?
Good, I think. Kachi's got a sister up in Memphis. We were coming back from visiting her. We were in a gas station and some guy grabbed my boy. I thought he was kidnapping him. I was on the fucker in about 2 seconds and... Christ. Just lucky I was there. We saw a lot of bodies before we stumbled upon Herschel's. But we're a tough family, Lee. Ain't nothing gonna faze us.
See you.
It's not the most reliable pickup in the world, but it gets the job done.
You know how to drive it?
Sure don't. I can give you a hell of a critique of the U.S. Farm Bill, though.
I'm good.
How are these things to drive?
Awesome!
Pain in the ass, mostly. Big, heavy as hell, and slower than, Hey, Lee.
Need a hand?
That'd be great. If you could cut those two-bys to length, that'd sure speed things up. My dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
Was the boy one of the walkers?
I don't even know. He was either attacking the guy or asking for help. He didn't even hesitate. He just turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes, and pulled the trigger. You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
They don't fall like you think.
Did you have to do it?
Do what?
Kill. Have you had to off one yet?
Oh, I had to shoot one.
I could shoot one. Maybe. If it were far away. I'm just glad we're getting this fence built. Dad just wants to keep the...
How'd you get out of Atlanta?
I was on my way out anyway. The timing of all this just happened to be right.
Huh. If there ever is a good time for the supposed apocalypse.
This farm's a nice plot of land.
Huh. Had you told me 20 years ago I'd still be doing this, I would have told you that you were full of crap. Never was a plan, having a place like this. It was in the family, and I guess so was I. Family's important. It's all that matters. You agree with that?
Was brought up to, yes.
Where's your family now? Parents? Wife? Girlfriend?
No wife. Not anymore. I think she's up in Virginia, maybe.
Sorry to hear it. But now you've got this little girl to take care of. Clementine, is it? You just stumbled up on her?
What are you getting at?
Can I give you a piece of advice?
What is it?
I don't know who you are or what you did, but you better become a better liar and fast. Let's say things don't get better back in the cities, or they get worse before they do. You're gonna have to depend on the honesty of strangers if you're gonna make it. And if those same people get to questioning yours, you're gonna be in trouble. So whoever you are and whatever you did, keep it to your damn self. Oh, and I'd start checking the attitude, friend.
Go! I'll get my gun!
My leg is stuck. Get the fuck out of here!
I'm sorry.
Sorry?
Your son is alive.
You don't get to be sorry. And you! You didn't even try to help.
I thought I could help them both.
Look at him. You thought wrong. And now?
Please. Just go.
Get out and never come back.
Got that ride to Macon if you want it. This is as far as we're going.
Then it's far enough.
Look!
Hey there. You friendly? Truck's run out of gas. Fuck!
We're trapped!
Take risks like this. And we can't just let people die, either. When I say that door stays shut no matter what, I fucking mean it. We don't know who these people are. They could be dangerous.
Worse, they could have let them right to us.
Where the hell is your humanity? They would have died out there.
Then we let them.
We have kids with us.
I see one little girl.
What is it?
I have to pee.
I'd go out there again in a second.
I bet you would. You're a dumb, careless kid.
I would too.
In a minute, Clem.
They've got kids, Lily.
Those things outside don't care.
Maybe you should go join them then. You'll have something in common. God damn it, Lily. You have to control these people.
Carly and Glenn just ran out there.
I don't give a flying fuck. We're in a war zone.
She's the leader here. But it looks like she's losing control of her people.
If you were in my shoes, you'd be the...
Holy shit.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
He wasn't bitten.
Hell, he wasn't. We have to end this now.
Over my dead body.
We'll dig one hole.
No, I'm cleaning him up. There's no bite. He's fine.
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen. We let someone with a bite stay in, and we all end up bitten.
Shut up.
We gotta throw him out, or smash his head in.
Kenny, stop him!
What do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy. It's...
Lily, I'll handle this.
But your heart, Dad. You need to calm down.
We kick his ass.
That's what I'm thinking.
Everyone, chill the fuck out! Nobody is doing anything.
Shut up, Lily. And you, shut the fuck up. They will find us, and they will get in here, and none of this will fucking matter. But right now, we're about to be trapped in here with one of those things.
What the hell are you talking about?
He's bitten! That's how you turn!
He's not bitten. Lee, stop this. It's upsetting him.
Oh, I'm upsetting him. Upsetting is getting eaten alive.
Dad, we get it. It's a big deal.
Sit down. That's it.
You're gonna whoop me? You and what homo parade?
This one.
That's good. Little boy,
Before you eat your mommy, you can watch your dad get his nose broken.
I'm gonna kill him, Cat. Just worry about Duck.
Lee!
Yeah?
There's someone in there.
It's just locked. Key's behind the counter. Probably.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. I'm just looking out for my daughter.
No, you're just the guy arguing for killing a kid.
He's covered in muck. She'll find the bite. Watch.
She won't.
And if she does, the first thing he'll do is sink his teeth into his mom's face. Then, when she's dead, he'll probably pounce on your little girl. She'll turn fast. And then, there'll be three. And that boy is the ball game.
Then we deal with it then. But right now, we're just freaking everybody out.
Then get ready to deal with it, because that boy is bitten.
It's not gonna happen.
It is. And we're tossing him out now.
Knock this guy out.
Happily.
Jesus.
Oh, man.
Jesus!
Get away from her, you son of a bitch!
You okay?
Just great, thanks.
Guys?
Everybody down! Stay quiet!
They're gonna get in!
Shut up!
Is that the military?
I don't know.
Thank God for whatever it is.
We almost died because of this bitch and Richie Triggerfinger. That was stupid. That was...
Dad!
I did try to get him to calm down.
Can it, asshole? It's his heart.
My pills.
Nitroglycerin pills?
Yes, we're out. We've been trying to get into the pharmacy since we got here. Please try to get in there. Behind the counter where the pills are.
What are we looking for?
We need nitroglycerin pills. Please get in there. I'll keep an eye on my dad.
Everyone else should get comfy and look for anything useful. We could be in here a while.
I'm starting to think this drugstore isn't a permanent solution.
You're right. This ain't exactly Fort Knox.
What do you suggest?
We need as much gas as possible so we can all get out of downtown Macon. Fast.
Agreed.
Then I'll head out and get gas. There's a motel not too far from here, out towards the end of Peachtree. I'll work my way towards it and then loop back, siphoning what I can.
You know your way around? Local?
Born and raised.
If you're gonna do that, here's a walkie-talkie if you get in a tight spot. Hopefully, you won't need it.
Cool.
Clementine's got the other one. Check in with her and get back here as soon as you can.
And you, what's your name?
It's Lily. My dad's Larry.
Keep a good eye on him. These boys will work on getting you your medicine.
That's right.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it. For now, get some rest. You're a good shot, and I'd like to keep it that way.
You got it, boss.
Now get him those pills.
Central High Tech State. Papers a week old. Feels like years. What are you messing around with there?
A radio. I can't get it to work, though.
Here, let me have a look. Nothing.
are no batteries in this thing.
What now?
You know that there are no batteries in that thing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah. No.
I can try to find some. Needs two.
Thanks. I wouldn't even really know what to look for.
We just need to get back to Fort Lauderdale.
We'll do our damnedest.
I don't remember them very well.
Try to get some rest, hon.
How can I with those things out there?
Hey, Lee. Maybe punching him wasn't such a good idea.
There were worse plans.
Says the guy who didn't get punched in the mouth. Anyway, we, Kat and I, appreciate your support.
Thank you, Lee.
How's Duck doing?
He's okay. It was just a shock.
We're lucky as hell nobody got nabbed on the way in here.
No kidding.
How's she doing?
She's good, I think.
She's a tough one right there.
She's just a little girl, Ken.
Were you saying, Lee, she spent days surviving on her own?
That's right.
Not just any little girl can do that.
What's the plan?
Hang tight, I suppose. Seems pretty dangerous out there, so we ought to wait for things to clear up.
You said your family was from here in Macon?
That's right.
Where are they? Should we go looking for them?
They, own this place. They're, gone.
Oh, sweetie.
Kat.
They were good people. I wasn't around much, but yeah, they're dead. Are you guys all right?
We're just fine, considering.
How about you, Duck?
We've all been through a lot.
Lee, you got a second?
Sure.
Back on Herschel's farm.
Yeah.
We didn't even try to save him. That blood is on our hands, you know?
It happened pretty fast.
I guess. But I can't stop seeing him in my head.
We can't kill ourselves over
We him. Killed that boy. We could have saved him together.
We did what we could. Bad things happen. We didn't make a choice that killed Sean. You think you do when you look back on it. But in a moment, when things are really out of control, you don't have any choice.
I guess.
Try to let it go. It's not damaged. Glad this place didn't get looted. Looks like nobody got a chance to donate anything before this all went down. Hey there.
Hi.
Any word from Glenn?
Nothing. Is he okay?
Yeah, I think so. You're doing a good job. Can I, get you anything?
I'm okay. Maybe I'm a little hungry.
I'll see about that. So,
are you okay?
What? I'm fine. I just, I'm good.
That's good.
Yeah, I think so. Being good is good, despite the circumstances.
Yep.
Well, sit tight.
Okay.
Not much, but here you go.
Thank you.
Of course. The pills are in there. How's he doing?
I'm not sure I got your name.
It's Lee.
Lily. My dad's Larry. I was just doing what I had to earlier.
Everyone was.
Now his heart's acting up again and I'm powerless to do anything. And that violence before with my dad, that didn't help.
What's wrong with him?
He's got a heart condition. He takes nitroglycerin tablets pretty regularly. I've seen a few bad attacks that he couldn't get over and needed to go to the hospital.
Yeah, that's not really an option right now.
I'm just trying to keep him relaxed.
He's got a temper.
Ah, fuck you!
Yeah, he doesn't mean it.
It's just that...
Yeah?
We've got kids here. Families.
He and I are a family.
I'm just saying some people can't handle a temper like that. Hell, barely seems like you can.
It's just his way. Don't make him the reason everything's screwed. Where's her mom?
Savannah, I think.
Oh, you guys aren't together.
No, I'm not her dad. I found her in a house when getting out of Atlanta. She'd been surviving by herself. I think the girl's parents didn't make it.
Oh.
I heard an answering message. They were in Savannah. She was home with a sitter. It wasn't good.
Well, she's lucky to have you.
What do you think about all this?
What is there to think? The dead are up, walking around, eating people, and turning them into more of them. I mean, Jesus.
We need to stick together and get through this. You're from here?
I work at Warner Robins, the Air Force base.
Yeah, I know it. Pilot?
Nah, just mechanical admin stuff. I deal with a bunch of shitheads and bureaucrats all day. Sometimes a plane, if I'm lucky. You?
I work up at UGA. Was anyone here when you guys got here?
No, this place was pretty wrecked. We pulled a couple of bodies out of the office. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Did you know anybody here?
Yeah, the owners, they were, we were close.
I'm sorry. We found an older couple in the office. Dad hauled them out in case they weren't really dead. I'm gonna get back to him.
Sounds good.